It is not even 50%. I can say it's 90% down.
Downtown Calexico is a string of small retail stores just north of the U.S.-Mexico port of entry. These small businesses are owned and operated by local families. They rely heavily on customers coming from Mexicali. But since border crossing restrictions were put in place, business has been incredibly slow. That's how David Dadul, the store owner of Casa Imports, describes this past year. He says the lifting of restrictions on November 8th hasn't brought back many of his old customers.
I sit here all day to make one sale, you know, $10, $20 sale. You know, I used to do $1,000 at the worst day. I used to do $500 and I complain about it. Now, I'm down to one sale.
He isn't exaggerating. Okay. Dadul keeps track of every single 11, item he sells. 20. And today,
I haven't made a sale. I open up at 8 o'clock. I open up at 8 o'clock Tuesday, November 23rd, 21. No sale.
From the pandemic, border closures, supply chain issues, and an increase in gas prices, Dadul has taken hit after hit.
This is the worst I've ever seen. I've been here 10 years, 11 years.
He says about 70 to 80% of his customers come from south of the border in Mexicali. He believes long wait times and vaccine requirements haven't enticed many to cross the border and shop like they used to. Just a block down from Dadul is Francisco Beltran's store, Lulu's Moda. We were hoping for more sales and more people to come, but we still haven't received the people we were waiting for, he says. About 80% of his clients are also from Mexicali, and 20% are local shoppers. Regrettably, locals don't shop here. The people who come here are people from Mexicali. We make a living from the people in Mexicali, Beltran says. Walking through the streets of downtown Calexico, you see stores that have gone out of business during the pandemic.
You would see empty parking lots often, and it's just heartbreaking that those are businesses. Those are people that own those that are trying to be successful.
Barry Smith Bean is the vice president of the new Imperial Valley Regional Chamber of Commerce in El Centro. The chamber opened in September, but has been in the works for nearly 2 years. The regional chamber combined the El Centro, Imperial, and Westmoreland Chambers of Commerce. United as one, Bean says they'll be able to make a bigger impact in Imperial County, and they're hoping to reach neighboring cities like Calexico.
Now more than ever, the businesses just need our support.
Calexico's Chamber of Commerce closed down during the pandemic, leaving Calexico businesses to fend for themselves and find outside help.
We want to really launch, coming into this new year of 2022 with the Chamber, we want to launch some of those initiatives where we're able to work with the businesses and say, show us what you're currently doing and let us help you evolve. Let us help you find ways that you can reach more people.
The regional chamber represents about 300 businesses in the county, although some business owners like Dadul and Beltran haven't seen an uptick like they wanted. Bean says overall there has been an increase of traffic flow coming into the county, and as some businesses have closed, others have thrived.
There's been success stories as well through this pandemic, and I think the biggest thing that we can do is we have to support our local businesses.
According to the National Retail Federation, sales are still down compared to pre-pandemic levels, but stores saw an increase in foot traffic compared to last year. During Thanksgiving week, Beltran didn't see many customers. But he says he remains hopeful that things will pick up during the holiday season. Alexandra Rangel, KPBS News.